We would like to begin with paying our deepest condolences to Shri Karunanidhi ji, who passed away yesterday. We are all very sad at this development. We even considered postponing this press conference, but then we thought that it will have to be postponed for many days, considering the various programs that we have. So we decided to go ahead with it. I hope you would not mind that we are holding this press conference on this day at this hour. After having said this, I would like to hand over the mic to my colleague Shri Arun Shourie ji, who will talk about the subject that we have chosen for this afternoon press conference. The papers are being distributed to you. You will have a look at it very soon. After he has spoken, then if there is anything that Prashant Bhushan ji or I would like to add, we'll take talk about them very briefly, and then we'll be open to questions from yourself. So I now request Arun Shourie ji to take the mic.
You know, the several features in the last few days, several stories which have appeared, several statements which have been made by government, led us, especially the repeated falsehoods and the shifting statements of the government on the Rafale deal, goaded the three of us to start looking at the record and meeting persons who are knowledgeable, including persons from the defense forces, to understand what exactly has happening. And after this examination, we are convinced that this is an enormous scandal which jeopardizes national security. And hence we feel that the government must reveal the facts, especially the facts in relation to what the whole deal is going to cost the public exchequer. Secondly, we hope that the opposition parties will relentlessly pursue this matter the way the BJP had pursued offers at that time. With the same tenacity, the opposition parties must pursue the matter. And third, that I would hope that all of us in the media will just not leave this matter at all, because it concerns national security, it concerns the lives of our airmen and so on. And finally, that we in the media must beware of plants. Of plants by government, by plants by interested parties. It's very necessary to do that. I'll just take a few minutes to take you through the statement which is being distributed and all these annexures which have been put together by Prashant and his colleagues very meticulously. As you know, the original deal was based on a thorough study by the Air Force that they would require 6 to 7 squadrons of 126 planes, and they had whole project had 4 interrelated objectives. The first was that the complete requirements of the Air Force must be met. Second, that a part of it should be, part of the plane should be available at the earliest possible. Third, that we must acquire state-of-the-art technology so that we can produce those kinds of fighter aircraft ourselves. And that the one organization in the country which has had 50 years of experience in building aircraft, Hindustan Aircraft Limited, the public sector company, should further strengthen its capabilities so that we become self-reliant in producing aircraft of this order. This was the objective. And for this, negotiations went on for a long time. Detailed negotiations with all sorts of people. First there were 6 vendors, then they were vetted down to 2 vendors, and it turned out that Rafael was L1. And therefore, they settled on Rafael. Now, these negotiations were almost complete. And this is evident from various statements which were made by the Foreign Secretary, for instance, S. Jaishankar, who was, as you know, in the core team of Mr. Modi. On the 8th of April in 2015, just 2 days before the Prime Minister's visit to France, he told the press people in the briefing, giving the complete impression that yes, these negotiations are far advanced, HAL and all are in the discussions, and the Prime Minister and President of France will not be getting into the details because they focus only on the big picture, even in relation to security matters. This was 2 days before that. Similarly, statements by the CEO of Dassault, Eric Trempierre,
on 25th March 2015, just 2 weeks before.
2 weeks before that, that is on 25th March 2015, he also said, negotiations complete over here, we are very happy with HAL and so on. And of these negotiations, then suddenly it is announced in Paris that India will buy these 36 aircraft. But even in that, please remember, and these will be bought in a what was called a ready-to-fly condition. There was no mention now of the 108 planes which were to be made in India. There was no mention of HAL. There was no mention of transfer of technology. It was a completely new deal. Now, if it is a new deal, then you have to have new tenders. That's right. As Prashant just reminds me, it has not been disclosed at all as to who prompted this deal. The Air Force has not said that, our requirements are not 126 planes, but only 36 planes. The Ministry of Defense has not said. Ye raat ko ilham kaise aaya? Demonetization jaise. Kisi se baat nahi. Aur ekdam 36 planes. But even in that joint statement of our Prime Minister and the President of France, I want to just read out 2 sentences to you in which it says that the planes will be obtained by India, and I'm quoting, on terms that would be better than conveyed by Dassault Aviation as part of a separate process which is underway, on better terms. Please remember that. Second, that the aircraft and associated systems and weapons would be delivered on the same configuration as had been tested and approved by the Indian Air Force. This is also very important because, as you know, the entire rationalization today is, there are some new India-specific add-ons. Actually, there is nothing. Everything is in the RFP in the beginning. It is what was being negotiated, it is what had been settled. And now suddenly we are being told, no, there is a helmet. No, there are new missiles. But that's not the case. Even in the joint statement, they said it will be the aircraft and associated systems and weapons would be delivered on the same configuration as had been tested and approved by the Indian Air Force. Now, the only justification which was given was that in 2 years they will come. But in fact, as you know, now we are being told that the first batch will come only 4.5 years after the statement. And the complete set of 36 will come only by mid-2022. Now, if the government had stuck to the original request for proposals, then by now, not only would you have got 18 aircraft, which were to come in a fly-by, ready-to-fly condition, but they were bound to have begun production within 3 years. So even production within India would have begun. But all of that is forgotten. Now, it turns out that there is no evidence that there was any consultation. Of course, the Air Force and all, as Prashant reminds us, but it is on record, as Yashwanti will tell us, that the Cabinet Committee on Security met on this matter only 1 year subsequent to the announcement of the deal. Secondly, if you see Mr. Parikar's statements at that time, the Defence Minister, he is always saying, not my deal, it's the decision of the Prime Minister. It is the result of the discussions between the Prime Minister and the President of France. He is always distancing himself from those. And third, of course, as I told you, the Foreign Secretary, 2 days before his statement, is referring to negotiations which are going on for the 126 planes, which also shows that the Prime Minister's own core team did not know what was actually happening. Next point is that HAL was kicked out completely. This happened even though in March 2016 a work share agreement had been worked out between Dassault and HAL, in which HAL was to do 70% of the work on the 108 planes which were going to be produced in India. And Rafale's statement, which is included in the statement which has been given to you, shows that they were completely comfortable with the competence of HAL. So they were excluded, and my good friend Anil Ambani's company, which has absolutely no experience in producing anything in aerospace or in defense equipment, and which had been registered just 10 days before the deal was announced, they were given the lion's share. 30,000 crores worth of offsets were to be now given, of which 21,000 crores were to come to a company which had absolutely no experience at all, and which in fact at that time had a debt of 8,000 crores, that single company. Forget the debt of the my friend Anil's company, group company.
More than 1 lakh crores. Debt is over 1 lakh crores.
Prashant says that the debt of the group as a whole is more than 1 lakh crores. But even if you focus only on that one single narrow company, Reliance Defense, its debt already was 8,000 crores. And its loss, accumulated loss at that time, was 1300 crores. And they had no experience. So would Dassault have gone in for such a partnership without a nudge and a wink from the authorities? Unko ye kaise yaad aa gaya?
The offset guidelines of the government say very clearly, if you turn to the offset guidelines which we have annexed, they say very clearly that all offset contracts would have to be approved by the government regardless of their value. If you look at that offset agreement, the offset guidelines, which are at page 22, turn to page 22 of this press release, because now the government is saying that we had nothing to do with the selection of Reliance, that this was a decision taken by Dassault, that the government has nothing to do with the selection of Reliance as an offset partner for Dassault. This is what is being said. Now, if you see these offset guidelines, which start at page 22 and go to page 24, at the bottom it says, these defense of said guidelines shall come into effect from 1st April 2016 and at page 22, Approval Authority, Para 8.6, it says, all offset proposals will be processed by the acquisition manager and approved by the Raksha Mantri regardless of their value. So this is a complete cock and bull story which is now being spun by the government.
And the question is whether the acquisition officer processed this and did the Raksha Mantri sign it? If they did not, they violated the guidelines. If they did, then how does the government say ki nahi hamara to isse kuch hai nahi, ye to inki private path thi, just not the Reliance walon ki. And then I just want to go to the back to the point of that experience, because actually the group's record is that they have great difficulty in executing big projects. Whether you take that Delhi metro line going to the airport or the line railway line in Bombay, series of such projects, power projects, or even in the defense field, they bought that Fort Pitama. Now there, they had to produce five offshore petrol vehicles. And they are not able to do that. So could a foreign enterprise of this sort experience have just alighted upon a company of this record? It was only a way to benefit somebody at the cost of the public exchequer, at the cost of defense preparedness, and in violation of the guidelines, and to knock out the one company which has had experience in all this. So that's the second point. The third point, and I'll just end with that, that is this whole question of the price. Wo kehte tha hum reveal nahi kar sakte, kyun? Kyunki ye ek secrecy agreement hai. But actually speaking, the secrecy clause in the agreement relates only to the technical specifications and operational capabilities of the plane. It does not deal with price. And in an interview to India Today, Macron, President Macron, himself said, I think in March, he himself said that as far as the price and all is concerned, this is entirely for the government of India to determine how much they want to disclose. So secrecy is that.
Second, yes.
So not only that, they have forgotten, I mean, the fools have forgotten that their own Minister of State for Defense answered a parliamentary question on this very matter in the Lok Sabha and gave the price. And the price he said was, the price he said was 670 crores per plane. I'll tell you why they are not reminding you of that price now. 670 crores per plane, and that will include everything. And he listed all those things in that answer to parliament. Now, he said this will include requisite equipment, services and weapons, which probably, which presumably includes missiles.
Helmet also.
Helmet. Second, Mr. Parikar himself had disclosed it. Parikar had said that 126 planes would have cost 90,000 crores, so that came to 715 crores per plane. Shakespeare had said yes. We complete the CEO of Dassault, he had said, we completely go by the RFP and what we had submitted at that time regarding the price. The RFP itself has said that the price will include aircraft, weapons and missiles, warranty for 2 years, license for manufacture in India, transfer of technology and initial training. All that. And Shafi said, yes, we have never budged from that at all. So what has happened that the government suddenly says that no, no, the price is confidential? Why? Because by mistake or design, Dassault actually revealed the price, and that comes not to 670 crores per plane, but to 1660 crores per plane.
Both Reliance and Dassault revealed.
Yes, actually Prashant reminds me correctly. Both Reliance and Dassault revealed the price. So that means the plane is now
1,000 crores more per plane than was revealed by the government itself just a year and a half ago. Hence, my friends, I conclude the net result of all this is that there has been a gross misuse of office by which the original project for the acquisition of 126 fighter aircraft has been sabotaged. Therefore, national security has been jeopardized, an enormous additional burden has been placed on the national exchequer. Third, the one organization in the country which had this expertise and to which whose expertise we were to build by transfer of technology and actual production under license so that we can make these fighter aircraft ourselves, that has been pushed out. A private party which has had absolutely no experience in manufacturing aerospace and defense equipment has been handed an enormous financial benefit. This entire transaction, and I'm quoting my friend Prashant in this, is a textbook case of criminal misconduct, of misuse of public office, and of enriching parties at the expense of the national interest and national security and the public exchequer. And therefore, our appeal is that we in the media must not let this go at all. I can tell you, as a person who handled the matter in regard to Bofors, that Bofors was absolutely nothing compared to this. There was never a sudden change like this, in which you suddenly gave up the entire project. You did a new project without any new tendering. And the clue at that time was the shifting statements and lies of the government, and that's exactly the clue today. So that's the point that we wanted to stress, and all the supporting documents are in annexures which have been put to the statement. The statement sets this out also. And Yashwant Ji and Prashant will really, they know much more about these things than I do.
All those who have not got copies of the printed press release and the documents should give their email. We will immediately email everything, the whole PDF file with the annexures and the documents. So Arunji has pointed out what this scam is all about. I call it a scam because in my view it is definitely the biggest defense scam that this country has seen so far. I have been following defense scams for a long time. Arunji has been following it for an even longer time. And we can say with great deal of confidence that this is clearly the biggest scam involving, firstly, a loss of at least 35,000 crores to the public exchequer. Secondly, a compromise of our national security by reducing the aircrafts which the Air Force had asked for, which the Air Force needed, from 126 to 36 without, and I say this with authority, without a single person in the Air Force or a single person in the Defense Ministry saying that this requirement of 126 can be scaled down to 36. Not one person. I say this with authority. The present Air Chief, who happened to be in Paris on that day when this deal was signed, he told people that I know that I was not aware of this reduction from 126 to 36. From 126 to 36, he said he was not aware of this. Parikar said that he was not aware of this. Nobody in the Air Force, nobody in the Defense Ministry had asked for this reduction. Mr. Modi, on his own, unilaterally takes this decision, signs a new contract, makes everybody believe that this 36 would be delivered on the same weapons platform, on the same technical specifications, at better prices. But what we find now, according to the press releases of both Dassault as well as Reliance, that the price has in fact been increased by at least 1,000 crores per aircraft. More than doubled, clearly. And the reason why they have been caught and the reason why they are hiding on secrecy is because they inadvertently stated on 18th, if you see page 27 of the press release, in November 2016, this fact is not brought out sufficiently, that today the government says that price can't be revealed under the secrecy agreement. On November 2016, this very government stated formally in parliament that intergovernmental agreement with the government of France, the French Republic, has been signed on 23rd September 2016 for the purchase of 36 Rafale aircraft along with requisite equipment, services and weapons. Cost of the Rafale aircraft is approximately 670 crore and all the aircraft will be delivered by April 2022. After having said this formally in parliament, does it lie in the mouth of the government to say today that no price can't be revealed because it is covered by a secrecy agreement? And the reason why they have been caught is because Reliance and Dassault, if you see both their press releases which are there, both of them said, the first press release of Reliance is on page 30. In the middle of page 30 they say, on 23rd September, India and France signed a purchase agreement for supply of 36 Rafale fighter jets at a value of 7.87 billion or about 60,000 crores. So this is the Reliance statement. Thereafter you have the Dassault statement, which starts at page 32. Where on the top they say order intake in 2016, euro 9.558 billion. This is 36 Rafale and some Falcon. At page 34 they say that the Falcon order is 1.419 million, which makes the Rafale order to be 8.139 billion. So even more than what Reliance has stated. So Rafale is saying that the worth of the order of 36 Rafale planes is 8.139 billion, which is on today's prices 65,000 crores. So 65,000 crores for 36 planes today, it comes to more than 1700 crores per aircraft. And as I said, the government is hiding, is saying that no, Reliance, when this question was raised, how is Hindustan Aeronautics kicked out and Reliance brought in? Government now feigns ignorance and says, we had nothing to do with it. Arre, ye to Dassault ne sign kar liya, unke paas tha, jisse bhi agree kar le. But then we found this offset guidelines of the government itself, which came into force in April 2016, just 5 months before the deal is signed by this very government. And this guideline says every offset contract, regardless of value, has to be approved by the Raksha Mantri. By the Raksha Mantri, by the Defense Minister. And today the government says, अरे उन्होंने 20,000 करोड़ 21,000 करोड़ का कॉन्ट्रैक्ट एक बोगस कंपनी को अपने आप दे दिया, हम क्या कर सकते हैं इसमें, हमारा क्या इससे लेना देना. एंड देन दिस स्पिन अबाउट इंडिया स्पेसिफिक अपग्रेड, अरे हमने 6 डॉक्यूमेंट्स लगा दिए हैं इसमें इन देयर एनेक्सर्स व्हिच से रिपीटेडली अगेन एंड अगेन एंड अगेन that the negotiation for the first contract was with everything. That was the RFP, with maintenance, with weaponry, with everything. That's the statement of the government in parliament also, 670 crores includes everything. That's the statement of the that Parikar also, CEO Eric Trapper, said that we are not moving out at all, we are not budging from the RFP, we are going to stick to the RFP and deliver according to the RFP. this Parikar says that we cancelled that 126 plane deal because that would have been too expensive. It would have cost us 90,000 crores for 126 planes, which comes to 715 crores per aircraft. And now we find that they have signed a deal for 36 aircraft for 65,000 crores, which comes to 1700 crores per aircraft. Or isliye, that is why they are hiding behind secrecy, because they know that as soon as they put the papers on the table, the game will be up. And as Arunji pointed out, this has several implications. First, they have completely compromised the security of this country. Air Force for the last so many years has been saying we are short of at least 7 squadrons and we need 7 squadrons. On that basis, that RFP was floated for 126 aircraft, and that is reduced suddenly to 36 without anybody, nobody in the Air Force, nobody in the Defense Ministry, and the plea given is ki, no, that would have been too expensive. And therefore 36, when you almost 2.5 times you have made the price of the aircraft. And Make in India, which was one of the center pieces of that earlier program, that you will acquire the technology to be able to make this aircraft in India. One other thing, you see, Make in India would initially be more expensive than buying ready to fly, because initially you have to set up the plant. You have to pay the cost of transfer of technology. But even with all that, according to Mr. Parikar, the price was still 715 crores per aircraft. If you had to buy ready to fly, it would have come to less than that, less than 715 crores, because Make in India would involve long-term benefit, but in the short term you have to pay a higher price, because in the long term you will be able to manufacture these planes in your own factory in Hindustan Aeronautics. All that is given a go by. And then one of the other lies being told to us is, no, this is a government to government deal. How can there be any hanky panky in a government to government deal? It is like, suppose our government entered into an agreement with France कि भाई हम आपको अनिल अंबानी ये बना रहा है ये फ्रिगेट, वो फ्रिगेट जो है हम आपको 10,000 करोड़ के सप्लाई कर देते हैं, एंड आप फ्रेंच गवर्नमेंट से ठीक है उसका ऑफसेट जो है 50% आप हमारे आदमी को दे दीजिएगा, और ये गवर्नमेंट टू गवर्नमेंट डील हो जाती है. Can you say that because it's a government-to-government deal, therefore there can't be any hanky-panky? I mean, it makes complete nonsense of this. I mean, if there is a corrupt government, it will certainly enter into a deal. Dono ko fayda ho raha hai, dono ke logon ko fayda ho raha hai. Udhar usko higher price mil raha hai, France ko, for the same aircraft, unki company ko, aur yahan par inke crony ko offset contracts mil raha hai. So, one after another, this whole process has revealed the lies of the government. The first lie was that price can't be revealed. Second lie was that this 126 was brought down to 36 because 126 bahut mehenga ho jata. Third lie was that offset contract was decided by Dassault. Fourth lie was that this was cheaper, that this new deal of 36 aircraft is cheaper than the previous deal, etc. And then they ask, any corrupt deal to ye nahi hai? That because ki add-ons ho gaye. Now we have busted that add-ons business by pointing out that the earlier deal had everything. And the government has stated that 670 crores is the price inclusive of everything. How are we now, how is Dassault and Reliance now giving a figure of 60,000 crores for 36 planes, which has not been contradicted by anybody in the government? It means that in fact the agreement that has been entered into is at a price which is at least 1,000 crores more per aircraft than the earlier contract, more than double. And then they ask, ye isme to corruption nahi hai, dekhiye Bofors mein to middleman tha, isme middleman kaun hai? Are bhai Ambani kaun hai? Ambani kahan se aa gaya is deal mein? 21,000 crore usko aise phukat mein aise hi mil jayenge. They are saying, who is Q? Everybody, this is Q and A. This is the Q, this is the A of the Rafale scam. And as Arun bhai said, that this is a textbook case of criminal misconduct. Dekhi, abhi unhone ek kaam kiya. 10 din pehle ek parliament ne isme prevention of corruption act ko amend kar diya. और क्रिमिनल मिसकंडक्ट जिसमें कि 2G और कोलगेट में सारे पब्लिक सर्वेंट्स को चार्ज किया गया है उसको हटा दिया. सेक्शन 13 क्रिमिनल मिसकंडक्ट हैज बीन रिप्लेस्ड बाय अ न्यू सेक्शन. व्हाई? अब देखिए क्रिमिनल मिसकंडक्ट कैसे डिफाइंड था. इफ ए पब्लिक सर्वेंट गिव्स एन अनड्यू बेनिफिट टू एनी प्राइवेट पर्सन एनी पर्सन विदाउट एनी पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट or by abusing his power as a public servant, that's criminal misconduct. 13(1)(d)(2), 13(1)(d)(3). इसमें कोई पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट नहीं है. आपने प्राइस बढ़ा दिया, हिंदुस्तान एरोनॉटिक्स को भी हटा दिया, रिलायंस को ले आए, क्या पब्लिक इंटरेस्ट है? अनड्यू बेनिफिट तो दिया ही है, प्राइस आपने 1,000 करोड़ बढ़ा दिया और अपनी अथॉरिटी का मिसयूज करके. प्राइम मिनिस्टर को कोई अथॉरिटी नहीं थी विदाउट अप्रूवल ऑफ द कैबिनेट कमिटी ऑन सिक्योरिटी, विदाउट एनी रिक्वायरमेंट फ्रॉम द एयरफोर्स, विदाउट एनी रिक्वायरमेंट फ्रॉम द डिफेंस मिनिस्ट्री. ही हैड नो बिजनेस, नो अथॉरिटी टू एंटर इनटू अ न्यू अग्रीमेंट फॉर 36 प्लेन्स. एंड देयरफॉर दिस इज अ टेक्स्ट बुक केस ऑफ क्रिमिनल मिसकंडक्ट अंडर द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ करप्शन एक्ट ऑन विच मिस्टर मोदी पर्सनली वुड हैव बीन प्रोसिक्यूटेड. Would have been prosecuted. I mean, there is no escape from this whatsoever. As a lawyer, I can tell you, there cannot be a stronger case for criminal misconduct than this. And that is why this amendment has been made just 10 days ago to get them out, get them off the hook. Of course, the babus are also very happy that theek hai, ab aage se to hamara bhi prosecution nahi hoega. So therefore, as Arun bhai said, that all of us owe a duty to this country to keep our eyes firmly on this, to keep asking these questions, and so does the opposition of this country. And if this government had any shame whatsoever, they would stop hiding behind this smoke screen of secrecy and put out everything, all the documents on the table. The French Prime Minister has already said that he has no objection to this being done. Thank you.
Friends, I will be very brief. I have some experience of working in two important ministries of the Government of India. And I can tell you from my personal experience that when a high-level visit takes place, for instance, the Prime Minister of India going to France, then the joint statement is worked out in advance. To-ing and fro-ing takes place between the External Affairs Ministry, the PMO and the Indian Embassy and the French government. And then everything is tied up, the joint communique is ready, the principals only give their approval and then it is put in public domain. That is the procedure. When the Foreign Secretary says, 2 days before the issue of this joint statement, that we are pursuing the older contract of 126 planes, then clearly he was not in the know of the desire of the government or the Prime Minister to purchase 36 Rafale aircraft. And that is why he made the statement that he made, which we have given you in our statement. So the Foreign Secretary did not know, the Raksha Mantri did not know, because repeatedly he said, it is Modi ji's decision, I back it up. And the Cabinet Committee on Security, which should have taken the decision first of all to scrap the earlier deal for 126 and then authorize the negotiation for the 36 aircraft. That was not in the picture at all. It, as Arun ji said, it came in the picture a year later. So who took this decision? The decision was taken by just one person in the government, and that is the Prime Minister of India. He had no collaborators in this venture. He rode alone. We made a mockery of Make in India, which is such a huge slogan of this government. And then, I like to point out one more thing which came to my notice as I was coming here, that as you are aware, we have a very large contingent of the Russian fighters, Su-30 MKI and the Tejas, which is a light combat aircraft, is also under production. Now, the Air Force's plan was that both the Su-30 MKI and the Tejas will be equipped by missiles, air-to-air missiles, and the Meteor air-to-air missiles and the cruise missiles, subsonic cruise missiles, that these aircraft will also be equipped with them. And there was discussion going on with MBDA, French-led European Missile Consortium, for the purchase of these. Now this great add-on secret weapon that nobody knows about are these missiles, air-to-air, with which the Rafale aircraft will be equipped. But what has happened is that no sooner was the contract for these 36 Rafale aircraft was concluded, that MBDA has walked out of these negotiations, and they are saying that we cannot supply you these missiles because our secrecy will be compromised. And there are defense experts who have told me that the French were actually waiting. They kept the Government of India Air Force engaged in the negotiations until the Rafale deal was concluded, and then said, we are not interested in equipping your other aircraft. And these defense experts tell me that if for nothing else, for this reason, the Government of India should cancel the contract with Dassault for the supply of these 36 planes, because they have not played fair with us. So friends, there has been a demand from the Congress party that there should be a joint parliamentary committee which would examine it. We know that this Lok Sabha is on its last leg. So a joint parliamentary committee will never function so quickly as to give us the results in this Lok Sabha. I would suggest on our behalf that the audit which CNAG was supposed to take up, that should be a forensic audit, and it should be completed by the CNAG within 3 months. Within 3 months, the CNAG should complete the forensic audit of this particular deal and place the findings before the nation. It is a huge scam, there is no doubt about it. Bofors pales into insignificance before this scam. We have no party interest, three of us here, but we thought national duty demanded that we come before you and place these facts which have been well researched and they are in your hands. We have to fight this battle. We have to prevent this loss to the national exchequer. This is our national duty. This is all also your national duty. Thank you.
Can I just add one small point? I mentioned to you how we have to beware of plants. I'll give you an example from yesterday, one of our major papers. This story is, no, अभी हमने सबने कहा कि अगर न्यू डील थी, if you are cancelling something and then suddenly there is a new deal, you have to go through certain procedures. So they say, yes, yes. You see, what happened was that during the course of the negotiations, it became clear that actually speaking, this all could no longer be the L1. And in the meantime, the rival Eurofighter had written to the Indian Defence Minister. We quoted the letter, and we annexed the letter also, a letter from Eurofighter saying we are prepared to reduce our price by 20%. So these people now say, see, this Dassault could no longer be the L1. Therefore, we thought we should scrap the old deal of 126 and go for some new deal. In fact, as Prashant has said, all of us have said, the new aircraft are twice what you were negotiating at that time, twice the cost. But the other point is it if paper should have realized this when they swallowed and vomited this plant, that is the policy of the government to keep one particular vendor at L1 so that it can get the contract? Or is it the policy of the government to get the best deal for India? And if in your own say so, it is now such that you have to go through a new deal, then there are all sorts of requirements which you have to go through, including a new tender, a re-examination of everybody's bids and so on. None of that was done. So we should be very careful about both the very skilled government in planting stories in channels and newspapers, and also in other commercial people who may be benefiting from this and who have unfortunately inroads into all of us. Thank you.